And we're going to be testing, and the only difference between this and your Z-score test is the fact that we do not know your population standard deviation. So if we do not know your population standard deviation, we have to use your test statistic. So we'll be using your
God bless.
sample, God bless you, your sample standard deviation. And if you put this in your L1, if you have to put anything in your L1, it's your SX. So we'll be using your sample standard deviation through this because we don't know your population standard deviation. The rest of it fairly works the same way. And it has a great calculator step. When we do this, we'll do the formulas and we'll go to the calculator. When you go to the calculator and you go to test, there's a Z, there's a T. There was your Z interval, there was your T interval. So the only difference here is instead of the population standard deviation, it is asking for a sample standard deviation. That is the only difference. So what you always have to check is, do I know the population standard deviation? If I know it, it's a Z score. If I don't know it, it's a T score. So that's the only difference here. Your N, it still has to tell us if it's normally distributed or my sample size is greater than or equal to 30. I still have to know that. Guidelines, again, we're going to be finding your level of significance. It's given to us in the problem. We're going to find your degrees of freedom because that's what your table uses, degrees of freedom. You're going to find your in here using the hypothesis test. If it's left-tailed or right-tailed, you go to the one-tailed place, one tails, and you look up exactly what you need. If you go to a two-tail, you do not have to subtract anything. You're just going to go to your two-tail. Okay, and you're going to get obviously both signs. All of this table is in positives. So again, we just have to kind of place it. So if you want the critical value for a left, this kills my eyes. It doesn't hurt your eyes. Oh, it's killing my eyes. I can't keep looking at this. Find the critical value for a left tail test. So a left tail test. That means this. That means two things. We can still do your reject region with this. We can still do your p-val. Now, if you notice table 5, table 4, all of that information inside, God bless you, is your p-val. Does table 5 contain a p-val at all? If you look at table 5, what kind of numbers do you see? Are they greater than 1 or less than 1? Greater than 1. Is your area ever greater than 1? No. Your table 5 does not contain a p-val, ever. It just has like a t-score value, a t-value. So if we're going to ever test with a p-val, you have to use your calculator. Your calculator will give you a p-val. This table will not. So most of our work will be with rejection region. Reject H0. Hence, we need a critical value. This is failed to reject H0. We will do a p-val test, but we can't do that unless we use the calculator. So if I want this left tail and my N is 21, my degrees of freedom is 1 less. Go down the table to degrees of freedom 20 and follow the one tail for the 0.05. So go to 20 and 0.05 and tell me what that value is. You're in the one tail, 1.725. So if I put this here and look at it, they're all positive in my table. Should this be from my graph a negative or a positive? A negative. I just make it the negative. So now I know what my cutoff value is. So when I test this and I get a T equals blah, 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 and I come out with my T, I'll know where it falls and I'll know what my decision is. You cannot get a p-value from this table. You can only get your cutoff value. Make sense? We could do an inverse t, but your inverse t will only give you your p-value for this guy. It won't give you your p-value for what we need. You'll get your p-value from your test on your calculator. So find me this. Again, this is my TC. This says reject H0. This says fail to reject H0. Find me my critical value. Look it up on your table. Are you a one-tail test or a two-tail test? One. Jillian, put your phone. What'd you get? 2.650. So should my graph show me positive or negative? It's a negative. Easy peasy, right? Pretty easy. Okay. A right tail test. This is going to be reject H0. Fail to reject H0. Critical value. Am I a one-tail test or a two-tail test? One-tail test. So I'm going to look up in my table under one-tail. What's my degrees of freedom? 16. I'm going to look up my 0.01. 2.583. So when I put it here, that's a t. Sorry. Does that stay positive or negative? Positive. That's pretty easy. Agree? Okay. Let's jump to a two-tail test. Two-tail test. We have two regions for reject H0. A negative TC and a positive TC. What's my degree of freedom? Okay, so I want to look up a two-tail test. I want to look up a level of significance of 0.10, and I want to come to 25.
Would you divide by 2 first?
Let's see what your table gives us. So what did your table give us? 1.708. Now, normally, if we were doing a z-score, we would divide it by 2. But your table says 2 tails. And your table says, yeah, I know, I have to divide this by 2 and find it. You don't have to worry about it. So whether you look up a 1 tail, it'll give it to you. Whether you look up a 2 tail, you're in a completely different row. So if I was, so let's just take it from here. If I took half of this, 0.05, and I looked up a 1 tail, 0.05, and I came down to 25, follow this. If I had to do this myself, and I want to look up this thing for 0.05. Find me a one tail, 0.05, with the degrees of freedom of 25. What is that number? Look at your table. One tail, 0.05, degrees of freedom, 25. What's that number? Oh, 1.708. So your table handles your two-tail test. You can. If you divide it, then you've got to go to a one-tail, not a two-tail. So don't do any of that. Let your table do it. If you have a two-tail, you just go to the two-tail horizontal part. So you're there. If you have a one-tail, you go to your one-tail. You do not have to divide anything in two. If you did, you would be a one-tail, and it would still give you the same information. See where I'm going with this? Do you see the difference? If I divide it myself, I go to a one tail. That gives me 1.708. If I just read my two tail for 0.10, let my table take care of it, I get 1.708. So that's the beauty of this table. It allows you to do one tail, it allows you to do two tail, and you don't have to think about dividing anything. And again, of these, this guy has to be the negative. Pretty simple. All right, try this one for me. Two-tail test. If you want to call it t sub 0, you want to call it tc, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to get a headache by the time I'm done with this. So, look this up for me. I have a two-tailed test. What's my degrees of freedom? 15. Everybody get this? This guy is negative. This one in half really is pretty simple. This one in the proportions, pretty simple. Okay. Everybody okay with finding these? Alright. I really can't. Alright. So now, your test statistic, your z-score, look like this. Only difference. Z-score, only difference is I know my population standard deviation, I use my sigma, my small k sigma, population. If I don't know my population standard deviation, I use my S, sample standard deviation. The only difference. The rest of this goes the same. And they're still going to have to tell us that you're approximately distributed, blah, blah, blah. So, again, verify that you do not know your standard deviation. I gotta read from here. Verify that you do not know your standard deviation. State your claim. Make your sketch. We did this. This isn't going to change. Identify, here's where it comes into yours. Identify your degrees of freedom. Look it up on your table. Use a one tail, use a two tail. Get your graph. Let's reject H0 and test it and make a decision. I'll also show you once we do it in your calculator where to find your p-value. Right now, all we can do is, according to your book, is just reject it, H0, from your graph. So let's try one. Example 4. A used car dealer says that the mean price, we're still using mean, of a 2-year-old sedan in good condition is at least $20,500. So, this is what he says. This is his claim. Dealer's claim. Is that his claim then? So, what is his claim in math sentence? The mean is at least greater than or equal to. Now, I'm the car dealer. Would I want to tell you that the mean price is less than this? No, because everyone I have on the lot is going to be greater than this. And you're going to say, but you told me it was less than or equal to this. He's going to absolutely say greater than or equal to this. This is the least that you're going to find this car. It's going to be probably this and more. So is this my HO or my HA? What's my HA? What tail test am I? Left tail, good. I'm following the arrow of my HA. This you have to label, reject HO, fail to reject HO. You're gonna find a critical value for this. So let's read on. You suspect that this claim is incorrect and you're challenging it. So you find a sample of 14 similar vehicles. Their sample mean is 19,850. And their sample standard deviation, it's in the same sentence as when they discuss sample, is 1,084. At a level of significance of 0.05, you want to know, can you reject the dealer's claim? Since I used the word reject, what does my claim have to be, HO or HA? HO. So it's fitting into place. Is it my claim HO? Is it my graph HA? Right? Okay, critical value. How do I find that critical cutoff value? Table 5, what's my degrees of freedom? 13, am I one-tailed or two-tailed? One-tailed, go look in the one-tailed section at the 0.05. The tell me what you get. Seven, seven, one. So because I'm on the left side, I am negative. Now comes when I test. This is my sample information. I'm going to test. This is my test statistic. So t is equal to x minus the mean over the sample standard deviation. So we're going to put in your values. 1850 minus 2500 over my standard deviation divided by the square root of n. I put this all in my calculator, and I come up to negative 2.244. What's my decision? Reject HO. I want to see that decision, guys. Decision. This is your decision. It falls in here. Negative 2.244. So therefore, my decision is reject HO. And how do I interpret this? I go to my graph, my chart, my box. If I reject HO, then I don't have enough information to support that. I don't have enough information to use this or whatever. I support this guide, but I need to follow what I'm looking at, and I need to say it the way the box says it. So when you reject HO, you're going to say at a level of significance of 0.05, there is enough evidence to reject the claim that the mean price of a two-year-old sedan is at least $20,500. In your mind, you can say, I don't like that one, I like the other one, I want to support the other one, but you cannot put that in words. You have to follow that box.
You were just like, say what you just said, instead of saying the mean price of a two-year-old car, if I just said the dealer's claim, would it comes off
that? Yes. You have to use those words. In statistics, there are some things that have to follow, like it's kind of regimented, it has to follow that, and that's one of those things. Okay, now, when you go to your calculator, you guys that like the calculator, I love the calculator for these guys. T-test, it gives me my same information. Here's my mean, it comes from my claim, because my claim is about the population. Here's my sample, this is what we tested. Here's my sample standard deviation. That's the only difference you're gonna see. Here's my N. Use your N, not your degrees of freedom. Your calculator will figure out what your T cutoff is. It knows it. Follow my HA, so I'm following to the less than, and I'm calculating. There's my T-square right there. There's my P-val. Only your calculator can give you a P-val. You cannot get a P-val from Table 5. So your p-val is 0.0125. What did I say it was? 0.0125. 125. Was that right?
I don't know.
Or did I mess up the numbers? 0.0215. Okay. 0.0215. Now, if you want to test by p-val, level of significance, you get your p-val from your calculator. This is my p-val. This is my level of significance. This is less than, and this guy gets the equal sign. So my decision still is the same. Reject H0. The only problem here is you cannot find the p-val without the calculator. Fairly simple. This one's probably even easier because you don't have to worry about when do I divide it by two, when do I take the whatever I have to do. It does it for you. Your table is kind of nice for this one. Does it make sense? Yes? Okay, let's try another one. Okay, let's go to example 5. industrial company claims that the mean pH level of water in a nearby river is 6.8. You randomly select 39 water samples and you measure the pH of each. The sample mean and the standard deviation, which is your sample, it's all in the same sentence, is 6.7 and 0.35 respectively. Is there enough evidence to reject the company's claim? So if we use the word reject, does my claim have to be HO or HA? HO, so let's see if that is so. So my claim is, here's my industrial company, my claim is the mean is 6.8. How do I write that mathematically? Equals 6.8. And you're right, it's my HO. What's my HA? Doesn't equal, not equal to 6.8. What tail test do we have? So we have two areas where we can say reject H0. This part, you don't get another choice on this. You have to label, you have to say the words that they use. This is your hypothesis testing. So you took a sample of 39. You found its mean to be 6.7, its standard deviation, that's the S, 0.35, at a level of significance of 0.05. What's my degrees of freedom? 38. So I'm going to look at 38 in my table, and I'm going to look for which one, the one-tailed or the two-tailed? Two-tailed. I'm going to look for 0.05 or 0.025. 0.05, I don't divide it because I'm in the two-tailed. Go to your two-tailed. 2.024. Noah, you're right on this. This guy, left side, negative. Okay? So I'm halfway there. All I have to do now is my test statistic. So my mean minus the population mean over my standard deviation divided by the square root of 39. Make sure you use the N. When we do this, we get a negative because we're subtracting smaller minus larger. So what's my decision on this guy? Fail to reject. Look where it falls. This is where my zero is. This is a number line, so it falls in here somewhere. So my decision is fail to reject H0. So when I come here, I fail to reject this. I got to go along with this. I can't say I like it. I can't say it's true. I found it to be correct. I follow my chart. If my claim is my H0 and I fail to reject H0, there is not enough evidence at a level of significance of 0.05 to reject the company's claim that the mean pH level in the water of a nearby river is 6.8. I have to say it that way. Right? Let's put this in your cup and we'll get a p-val out of this. So I come down to your t-test. My mean comes from my statement about my population water level. My sample is what I tested. My standard deviation from my sample. My N. My two-tailed test. Now, your calculator takes care of the rest. There's your z-score. It knows it's a two-tailed table. There's your p-val. It already took its p-val and multiplied it by 2. You don't have to do anything to this. So 0.0824. This is your p-val. Do not multiply it by 2. It takes care of that. Your level of significance, 0.05. Fill this in. Greater than. Same decision. I want to see decision. I want to see interpretation. If I ask for a p-val, you have to use your calculator. So you're going to have to put this in your calculator. We'll do some with the calculator again on, we'll do example 6. When we come back on Wednesday, tomorrow, if you're not going to be here, bring your...